stuff like that are just so much harder, you know, through the winter months. And a lot of people just don't realize, you know, farming has been the backbone of our country for basically since it started, and it probably will continue to be. Problem is that less and less people are, I guess, into it or know about it. You know, most people today don't even know where their food comes from. It's in a package on a shelf is all they know or care about. If that, you know, a lot of people just run to the store or a fast food restaurant where it's already prepared. So it's, yeah, it's something I think it wouldn't be a bad thing to see, you know, a lot of our kids start to get back to the roots on that kind of stuff. I know I've tried to teach my daughter and, I've tried to teach other kids the value of growing things and of animals and of, you know, just the whole process in general, but that doesn't necessarily mean it sticks.
They don't realize that they're species farmers, and we have a lot of farmers in our area around here. They're not large corporate operations in any way. For a long time, these farms were being bought up by large corporations that were turning them into, you know, big commercial, instead of family operations, they were big commercial operations. Independent businessman, small farmer idea. But, you know, when people think of a small farmer is a guy that has, you know, and sometimes huge acres that he has to manage, and, you know, all the necessary equipment and supplies and doing that, and then running, it's a business, you know, and it's very complicated. When you say small farmer, I think that's misguiding people as to what, you know, it really is all about.
Absolutely. Small farming can mean hundreds of acres, you know, at the least, and lots of different things going on, you know. Yeah, some people farm one or two crops, other people farm several and have animals, you know. It's just, you know, it's a big misnomer out there that there's one thing to do. Mm-hmm. Who's that trying to get up in there? I saw. It was 8-bit. What's up?
You don't say that word on air.
Yes.
Twitter.
Oh, so we can't swear here?
No.
No.
Yeah, we try not to.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry. You didn't know.
Hurry up!
That was a self-fulfilling prophecy, though.
How you been, man? We haven't caught up in a while.
I am very sick. I just got out of the hospital. I'm all right.
Yeah, let's catch up. I'm not been on your end.
Not 100%, but I would say I'm 65%.
better than 50. I look at it that way, I guess. Just want to pop in and say hi to everyone. I heard Ape pop in. Haven't talked to you in a while, so. I'm gonna get back to work.
Hey, fam.
Yeah, what's up?
Happy Happy Resurrection Day.
Indeed. Yeah, back at you. Mm. Wonderful day. It's been a good day so far. Gonna be better, I'm hoping. We got a lot of stuff in the way. Got an Easter gift for everybody. Hopefully it'll be ready in time.
Oh, what are you doing? I just dropped in to say hello to all you guys. I recognize a whole lot of you names here.
Well, it's good to hear from you, man. Good to hear from you.
Definitely wanted to say hi. Well, it's good to have you back in here. We hope you come back more often. I can't see the storage section. Is that coming from higher authority? No, it's
still likely a non-land.
No, it's coming from literally everyone.
Literally everyone. That's kind of good.
It's not coming from higher authority. They probably wouldn't care. I don't know.
You're right.
Nice to have another voice on the live chat. Well, it's nice to see you guys again.
Yeah, man.
I know you've been busy, I'm sure. Especially lately.
I'm back in the positive.
No, I haven't really been busy. I've been
sick.
Sick as hell.
Yeah. Yeah, man.
So you guys, I'm in my ass, San Diego, and tracking this with 1,000 people in my team, you know, who are more there now.
Right. What's going on with that? You want to explain to everybody?
Yeah, so supposedly there is a massive storm coming up from South America through Mexico up to the border, seeking asylum, and their website doesn't look great either. But it's just more of the same.
It's
the constant theme, right? Where it's I need entry into your country, and you know what that means to you. After we get free homes, everything, right?
Yeah. Thank you. Ready to go.
This is like a website.
It's weird. Where exactly
are
they coming from? Is it just all over South America?
Multiple. Yeah, I mean, Mexico doesn't want any Hondurans in their country, right? So they're just kind of going all the way through the top.
You're taking a shower. I gotta check my phone.
Hey, why not, right?
I was saying that you.
Or the same.
There's a big thing on drugs right now. It links to a CNBC article, want to catch up on it.
So what part of the border are they planning to cross? Where are they trying to come in from?
Are they headed for Cali or Texas, Arizona, Phil? It's just a border, but I'm thinking all the way up to California.
That's what I would think.
Since we are a temporary state, right?
Yeah, well, Texas. Not right out here. Oh, you're in San Diego, you said?
Yeah, I'm super lucky over here. Oh.
Yeah. Well, hey, I can't man. It's gorgeous. I haven't been out there in a long time, but I miss it.
It's crazy. I mean, you know, growing up with my whole life, my folks are from here, everything. It's just so much changed in the last 20 years.
Yeah. Yeah, there's still plenty of parts of California that are with us. The vast majority, really, in terms of population, they're all concentrated in that one tiny part of the state, and they take care of the politics of the whole shebang.
I saw some video, like, I can't remember who it was from, but they were saying, like, California is not actually, like, it's not actually full lefty, like, crazy Antifa lefty.
No, I mean, San